El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Elyon Adonai. Age to age, you're still the same, by the power of your name. El Shaddai, El Shaddai, El Kamkon Adonai. I will praise and lift you high, El Shaddai. Through your love and through the ram, you saved the son of Abraham.
Hey, 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 and praise God for this glorious day. This is Zach Mitchell, your host of What Jesus Says. We want to welcome you back and being so faithful and joining us every Friday at 6:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to learn more about what Jesus has to say on controversial issues facing us today. This is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. We thank you for being with us tonight. We're looking forward to a faith-filled discussion on the good news of Jesus Christ. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Lord God, we thank you for all the many blessings you bestowed upon us today. We thank you for your love for us, that you even came and died for us. We pray that you give us guidance and wisdom in all things in order for us to rightly divide your word of truth. We pray for those that are less fortunate, those in the hospitals, nursing homes, hospices all over America, those that are unemployed, those incarcerated, even those that are on death row, that you give them peace, Father. We pray for our apostles, prophets, evangelists, preachers, and teachers all over the world. We pray for our churches, local and universal. We pray for our leadership all over the world. We pray for our enemies, that they cease from suffering and troubling, Lord God. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem, that we prosper, that love the holy city. Peace be in thy gates, prosperity in thy palaces. We pray for the salvation of Israel, that they come to know you as their God, Lord, and Savior, Jesus Christ. Pray for our soldiers, sailors, airmen, marines, and all our men and women, civil servants in uniform. We turn this broadcast over to you, Lord Jesus, and give you all the honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hello,
who do we have on the line?
We have Annie Mae Mitchell.
And are you lock, cock, ready to rock?
I'm lock, cock, ready to rock.
Okay. Turn off all that stuff. Let's see what Jesus has to say. You got anybody that's going to join you tonight?
No, right now.
Okay.
It's PBN. It's a religious station. And it talks about what Jesus says all the time.
There you go.
Every day.
That's right. His light, his word is light unto our feet, a lamp unto our pathway.
Lamp to our feet, and light in our pathway.
Amen. I got that backwards. See, you had to get me straight. All right. You
Absolutely.
Ready? So let's go to the 10th chapter of Hebrews. How about that?
10th chapter.
Hebrews 10. If you want to participate in tonight's conversation, dial 919-747-3572. This is Zach Mitchum, your host of What Jesus Says. And we're talking tonight from Hebrews, the 10th chapter, starting with the first verse. You ready?
Thank you. I'll let you read because I don't have it.
Okay, so here we are. For the law, having a shadow of good things to come, and not the very image of the things, can never with those sacrifices which they offered year by year continually make the commerce thereunto perfect. Did you hear what it said? Those sacrifices in the Old Testament could not make us perfect. Now, the Lord told us to be what? Perfect, even as he was perfect, is perfect. You understand?
Yeah.
So if he told you to do that, he has to make a way for you to be perfect, right?
Right.
And he said the sacrifices that were rendered back in those days could not make the commerce perfect. For then would they not have ceased to be offered? Because
that the worshipers once purged should have had no more conscience of sin. So once you're purged, you have no consciousness of sin. Jesus was tempted on every point, but was not found with sin. Just as we were tempted on every point. But in those sacrifices, there's a remembrance again made for sins every year. Now, this is the law. This is what people do when they have to try to follow the law. And they quoting you the law like Moses, telling you eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. And then Jesus come back in Matthew 23:23 saying, judgment, mercy, and faith. These you ought to have done and not over the latter, right? So he's looking at grace, mercy, and faith. And the law is talking about fulfilling the things that must be fulfilled in order to be in compliance. God is giving you grace now. For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sins. Take away sins. Take away sins. They cannot take away sins. Wherefore, when he cometh into the world, he says, sacrifice and offering thou wouldest not, but a body hast thou prepared for me. A body hast thou prepared for me. In burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin, thou hast had no pleasure. Then say I, lo, I come in the volume of the book, it is written of me to do thy will, O God. Above, when he said, sacrifice and offering and burnt offerings and offerings of sin for sin, thou wast not, neither has thy pleasure therein, which are offered by the law. Then said he, lo, I come to do thy will, O God. He taketh away the first, that he may establish the second, by which will we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. Listen, once for all time, one for all. I mean, so there's no more you calling yourself a sinner. Once Jesus was sacrificed, he took away the sin. See, the bulls couldn't do it, but the blood of Jesus through his body that was wounded for our transgression took away the sins of the world. So I don't understand what these people are coming off. We were born in sin. There's no way, because he took it once for all. And every priest standeth daily ministering and offering oftentimes the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. Did you hear what I said? But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, did you hear what he said? Sins for when? He offered this sacrifice when? Forever. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down on the right hand of God. What was your question?
You're reading 10, fourth verse, or young?
Now I'm on the 12th verse.
Okay.
From henceforth, expecting till his enemies be made his footstool. For by one offering he hath perfected forever them that are sanctified. So how are you perfected now?
By sanctification.
Through Jesus' blood. So now you're made perfect. He said, for one offering he hath perfected forever them that are sanctified. Whereof the Holy Ghost also is a witness to us. For after that he had said before, this is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, said the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts and their minds, and will write them in their minds. And their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. If you want to participate in tonight's conversation, you dial 919-747-3572. So that pretty much makes it clear that when Jesus died for us, there was no need for any more sacrifices. There's no need to be telling people that you are born in the sin, because that's not the case. He said he took away the sins of the world once and for all, right?
Yeah.
So when David told us that in the 51st chapter, that was a true statement. But nobody on earth, I think, is 2,000 years old, do you think? Do you think is anybody on earth over 2,000 years old?
No.
Okay, so nobody that was born after Jesus' death was born into sin because his blood reconciled us with the Father and served as an atonement once and for all forever. That's what the word said. Isn't that what it said? So how could you be born in sin when Jesus took away the sin of the world?
Well, that's what the preacher preached.
What?
That we're born in sin.
He didn't read the update. Now you got the 10th chapter to help them out, right? Hebrews 10.
All right.
I'm just saying, you heard it yourself, right? You want me to read it again?
Yeah, I heard about the covenant that I have made with you. These days, said the Lord, I will put my law into your heart and into your mind. Will I write them? That's what we just finished reading.
And what keep reading? What did he say?
And their sins and iniquity will I remember no more.
Okay. So why are you still remembering them then, preacher?
And he can't sit there and nowhere remission of these is. There's no more offering for sin. Having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiness by blood of Jesus.
Now, how you going to get in the holiness? Look, if you still a sinner, how you going to ever be sanctified to perfection?
In the blood of Jesus.
No, you missed what I said. If you're still a sinner, how you going to be sanctified because there is no more sacrifice for your sin. Jesus came and sinned and died for your sin once and for all. That was it. If you still a sinner, you're going to need another sacrifice.
Right.
That's stupid, right?
Yeah, that's right.
That don't make no sense. If you ain't no sinner no more, because if you're a sinner, you still need a sacrifice. He said there's no way that a bull or a goat can take away a sin, but the Lord requires a body that was prepared for him, right? And when he came, he died once for all forever. Forever means forever, huh? Aren't you part of forever? People after you are forever, aren't they? Aren't people coming after you considered forever?
People coming after me forever.
Yeah, that's what that forever means, right? What does forever mean?
What this has done has lasted forever.
That's what I'm telling you. How is the preacher then going to tell you still have sin?
I know what he's done for me. It's going to not last just today. It's going to last forever.
That's right.
So that's what he said.
Okay. So let's listen to that. Let's listen and and see what kind of God we serve. You want to hear that?
Yes.
Okay, hold on. Here we go then.
Welcome, Mr. Troy Bright.
How could he love me? How could he know me? How could one so awesome ever care so much for me? How could he love man enough to redeem man? How could he sacrifice his only son to set me free? That's just the way the Father is. He'll be your friend when you're not his. That's just his way. That's just the way. He's nothing like your other friends. He'll be with you until the end. That's just his way. That's just the way.
Why does he lose me? How could he put
Hallelujah. What do you think about that?
Troy Bright, ladies and gentlemen.
The part that I heard was the last part. It blesses me.
You didn't hear all of it?
That's just the way he is. Now, all that other, it's not clear to me.
It wasn't clear?
These two parts is enough for me to carry on. The way he is.
That's just
the way he blesses me.
Well. I hear you. Okay, well, look.
Just the way he is.
That's just the way he is. But look, you know what? We're going to have another opportunity later on to hear something else about him. And no, we don't worship no ordinary God, so we shouldn't have any ordinary worship. So we're going to worship him in spirit and in truth. The way he is that he came down even when we were yet his enemy, and he died for us once and forever. You understand? And for those of you that don't know the Lord, it's very simple. In Romans 10:9, he said, if you confess with your mouth, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart, God raised him from the dead, you're saved, because with the mouth, salvation is made. Confession is made to salvation, and with the heart, belief is made into righteousness. We'll believe that. And in Luke 11:13 says, you being evil know how to give your children good gifts. How much will your heavenly Father give you to have Holy Ghost if you ask him? And we believe that. And that's just the God we serve. So we don't want you to just go halfway. We want you to be fully drenched and immersed in the Holy Spirit. You understand?
Amen.
All right. That's just the way he is. So what do you think about what we talked about so far? We don't have to continue to kill bulls and goats and all that, and pigeons for our salvation. But I think Mary gave two turtle doves for Jesus' sacrifice. Say it again.
It's a good thought to know we don't have to depend on material things for our salvation, that Jesus has paid the price for us, and he has done it with his blood on the cross. And that's just what he is. By learning how he will bless us if we keep the faith.
Amen. Amen indeed. So look, let's listen to one more. Since you didn't get that, the devil's a liar, we're going to get a full worship service in. How about that?
Amen.
This ain't no ordinary worship. This ain't
this
Was that much better?
All I have. Gonna give it all I have.
Was that much better?
Much better, yeah.
Okay, so look.
And it's a good feeling to know that you're not gonna give him some, but all. How much? All I have, I'm gonna give it to him.
Amen. And he's gonna give you a blessing in return. So you wanna sum up what we talked about tonight about not living in the past under the consciousness of sin? Because after the blood of Jesus was applied, we have no more consciousness of sin, and now I'm made perfect for those that are sanctified through his blood. Because we could not be made perfect through bulls or goats, but he requires us to be perfect. The only way we can be perfect, like he says, be perfect even if your Father in heaven is perfect. And the only way we can do that is as a spirit, because Jesus is a spirit, God is a spirit. And who you worship in must worship in spirit and truth. You want to summarize what we talked about tonight?
Yes. It's a blessing to know that when you get to know Jesus, he is our personal Savior. And if we know that he's our personal Savior and that he has died for us on the cross for the remission of our sins, that let us know that we have been forgiven and that he is willing to bless us if we believe. And if we believe, he's going to give us all that we need and all that we want and all that he has. He's going to give it to us, all that he has. Trust and believe.
Amen. That was a good summary. So we're going to end on this, but just listen, based on what he's already done, he's true to his word. Amen.
This far, and I didn't think I could take it so long. There were days I wanted to quit. I said, surely this is it, but I held on. And I've watched as so-called friends turned and walked away. And it hurt so much, I didn't have words to say. But even when my day turns to night and nothing seems just right, Lord, I thank you for my life. For my life, Lord, I thank you for every victory. So I thank you for my life. And I've watched you take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you were near. Thank you, Jesus. And the moments I thought I'd fail, I was reminded of your nails. So and if I never live to see another day, There's nothing I would change or take away. I've had so many ups that they far outweigh my downs. Lord, I thank you for
you all for joining us this evening, and look forward to having you again next week on another edition of What Jesus Says. Amen.
Amen. And thank you so much for your time.
Master, teach me. Teach me how to wait. I would not live a liar.
All right.
Yeah. right.